I think, first of all, that we should be very grateful to Theo Kralt for discovering, so to speak, Discart. I know of many colleagues who work in this field, like François Pouillon, Mercedes Vollet, and they had never heard about Discart. So
around 15-20 years ago, I was, for my then employer, responsible for a country house in East Gelderland. And in that house, there were two large and one other portrait by Jean Baptiste Discart. Very little was known about the painter, only a sentence in the Bénézie Encyclopedia of Arts. But I saw that they were very good portraits. And I became fascinated by the painter. And I wondered whether these paintings were done by him alone, or that he also had done other paintings.
I think it's wonderful that Theo Kralt went all the way to write this beautiful book about Discart. He is almost unknown, or he has been unknown until now, but everything will change because of Theo Kralt's book.
In the first years, I just collected some material about the man. I discovered abroad also some data about his life. And I saw that in auctions or records of auctions, paintings by Discart turned up.
I was very pleasantly surprised when I heard about the project, because it fits also, among other things, very well into my work that I'm doing here in the Netherlands, like of finding out similarities or things that connect the Netherlands and Austria. This is one of the things.
Discart, it turned out, was born in Modena, then Austria, was educated at the Academy of Fine Arts in Vienna, then moved to Paris, then to Tanger. So he made first Orientalist paintings and later on continued with the portraits, and it turned out to be mainly Dutch portraits.
Things that connect the Netherlands and Austria, this is one of the things. This artist, but also an excellent painter, and I would have liked to know more about him. But now, of course, I went through the book in detail, and yes, I hope that it's going to be, that this painter is going to be also more known now in Austria.
English version, two Orientalist paintings that were not included yet in the Dutch version are included, 14 portraits and two chapters about themes of the painter life of Discart.
So why did he become such an important Orientalist painter? I would like to draw your attention that Vienna is also in one or the other way an Oriental city.
So I know that his paintings, his Orientalist paintings, they bring a lot of money. They are in huge demand among collectors in the Middle East and in North Africa. Does it mean that he is an outstanding painter? Well, I think it's not up to me, but I'd like to look at his paintings.
They left it to me which language to choose. Discart, of course, was Italian-speaking, German-speaking because of his time in Vienna, and French-speaking. In the end, we decided to let it translate in the English language because that's the most universal language now. And that makes it also possible to disperse the knowledge laid down in the book to a much more international environment.